Now, whether it's The Hobbit or Lord of the Rings, us Kiwis feel a special connection to the work of J.R.R. Tolkien, particularly on the big screen. We can thank Sir Peter Jackson for that.
We can indeed. But now there's a new Tolkien movie on the way that had nothing to do with Sir Peter. The man playing the lead role is a familiar face. And he told me he felt a lot of pressure playing the much-loved literary genius.
Nicholas Hoult and I have actually crossed paths before at this year's Oscars.
But yeah, it's weird. You go there and then people are screaming and shouting. There's loads of people. And it's like pretty nerve-wracking. And then you're like, oh. Then you wake up the next day and you're like, what was that all about?
So I have a confession to make. I did not yell and scream at you.
I just want you to know that. But I was on the red carpet.
Oh, yeah?
For the Oscars.
How was it?
I took a photo of you.
Oh, really?
Are you?
Let me see.
Excuse my cracked screen.
We both agreed he looked like he wanted to run away. But why?
It's pretty intimidating. But there's also like a sense eventually where you just kind of like block it out a little bit.
Intimidating was also how he described the task of playing the much-loved writer J.R.R. Tolkien.
Since childhood, I have been fascinated with language. I've invented my own.
You invented an entire language?
Yes. I made stories. Legends.
I hope we've done him justice, because the weird thing about playing real people is you kind of... I was a fan of Tolkien. I got given The Hobbit to read on the set of About a Boy and read it and loved it, and then played the card game after school and watched all the Peter Jackson films, which is why it's amazing to be here in Wellington. And so I had a connection to him, but I didn't know much about the man himself, so suddenly reading the script and learning about him and what an extraordinary life he had and his passion for language and the love of his life, played by Lily Collins in this movie, and the friendships and just how he created his mindset was phenomenal to me. So then the more I learned, the more I realised the weight of the task I'd taken on, and suddenly it became more and more precious.
What did you learn about him that you hadn't known before?
A lot. I was mispronouncing his name, I'm not going to lie. I was saying Tolkien, and then it turns out it's Tolkien.
It's pronounced Tolkien.
Lock that in, everyone. Tolkien.
Open yours, Will.
All right, thanks a lot. Marcus, is this a joke?
Yeah.
It's not bad.
Hoult made his Hollywood debut at just 11 in the movie About a Boy alongside Hugh Grant.
In terms of, like, an example of an actor to look up to and see and just have the right example set for how to treat people, how to prepare, how to be professional, all those sorts of things. That was like the perfect start point.
Over the years, has he given you further advice? Have you kept in contact?
We didn't keep in touch that much, to be honest.
Yeah.
Because I was 11, I went back to school.
Of course.
You know what I mean? So I wasn't like... I don't think I even had a phone, so I wasn't like texting him being like, hey, Hugh, what's up?
That 11-year-old grew into some pretty impressive roles and some pretty impressive costumes.
I have the feet at home. I sometimes just wear those as slippers around the house. Like these big blue fluffy beast feet. But also we were filming like near a golf course, and I'd jump out of the van like on the way back from set and like run across this golf course and like hide in the bushes whilst people were playing and like shout golf tips to them, and you could see they were thoroughly confused by this big blue fluffy monster running around.
Were they a little bit scared?
They didn't seem that scared, no, and they did listen to the tips I was given. So yeah.
Where you follow the rhythms of language. I have to tell you, Mr. Tolkien, I've never come across anything like it.
Now, before I let you go, I have a gift for you.
Oh, thank you.
Because you're only here for a few days.
Thank you so much.
So that's for you.
Lovely.
It's nice and small, so you can pack it in your hand like a...
Lord of the Rings location guidebook. Lovely. This is actually great, because I do want to try and get out if I have a moment.
That'd be great. So we hope you come back. And I wrote on the inside cover, so you can't re-gift it.
You have, unless I find someone called Nicholas to re-gift. Thank you very much, I appreciate
that. That's wonderful.
Lovely
to meet you.
What a lovely, lovely man. Never been to New Zealand before and didn't have time to go and look at Hobbiton or anything like that, but he's dying to come back and do that, so hopefully he does.
You two got on like a house on fire, didn't you? Now the movie's in cinemas here next week.